Hello everyone, it's me Zach here. Welcome back to another live stream. Now in today's live stream, we'll be doing the Platinum Jubilee from London Paddington to Taunton. Anyway, I'll just go quickly into the introduction of the slideshow of what the locomotive looks like. We'll be doing the Platinum Jubilee from, and then we'll be straight into it. So yeah. Welcome everyone, I hope you've all had a lovely week so far, and I hope you're all enjoying your half term. So, anyway, welcome to everyone who's seen this, and how is everyone? Right, we'll be back in just a second. So, there we go. That was a quick, sort of, short music into this sort of live stream. Ah, hello mate, how are you? So, yes, we've got the Jubilee pack. And so, we've got some photos of, taken screenshots of the game. And so, we'll be going straight into it in just a second. Hello mate, how are you? Good, good. I'm glad you're okay. Right, it is actually the official Queen's Jubilee on Thursday, so yeah, in just a couple of days' time, actually. So today is 31st of May, so yeah, Queen's Jubilee is on Thursday, the 2nd of June. Then that starts the bank holiday, really. So it should be fun. All good. It's all going to be good, really, because I've planned a couple of live streams, hopefully, to try and. So the first part's going to be taking the Jubilee to Taunton. The next one will be to Taunton to Minehead along the West Somerset Railway. And then it's basically just joining in part of the Jubilee, which would be the third one. So, yeah, third one would be just on the West Somerset and joining in with the rest of the locomotives. But we'll see how much I can fit in within about 4 days. Mind you, there are railways out there that are doing their own Jubilee sort of celebration, so this is, in fact, just me having a little bit of fun doing some random train sim stuff. And deciding to do a Queen's Jubilee, so Yeah, it's nothing really specific. It's not just... Currently, the locomotive that I'm going to be driving is at Severn Valley Railway. Okay, but here's the title. So, we are indeed at London. Yes, I forgot to mention that we've got the Class 800 from Armstrong Powerhouse. So, good afternoon, driver. Today you'll be taking the Platinum Jubilee from London Paddington to Taunton. After that, the train will go on to the West Somerset Railway for the Queen's Jubilee.
Ooh.
Ah, yeah, my half term's going very well, thank you, mate. Very well indeed. And to everyone who's watching, a big thank you very much, everyone, for 183 subscribers. We are so close to 200. So, if you are watching this for the very first time of me live streaming and you haven't just stumbled across the channel, then please do subscribe to the channel. Also, click the notification bell and do click that like button, because we are so close to 200 subscribers, actually. So, I'm hoping to hit 200 before the 1st of August, which is my end goal, really.
Good, good.
How's yours, buddy?
Okay,
misclick.
I'll click the wrong thing. Just close it. Anyway, right, let's get straight into the setup.
So, this is London Paddington, and I have, of course, left a link in the description below so where you can find it. And why is there a random car flying above my head? Oh, that's because there's a road. That's why. So, as I say, I've left a link in the description below to where you can find this route. Currently, we're sat at Paddington, waiting for our doors to be opened. Let's do control 6, 1 and 3, the head code, and we've got some nice 9 Pullman coaches, which are by Steam Sound Supreme, so go and check them out for yourselves if you would like to. And right, we're going to take that down. We're also going to put that open. We're going to be FM4 for today, because that's the best version. Oh, good, good. I'm glad your half-time's going very well, bud. This looks awesome. Oh, yeah, it is absolutely amazing. I love it. And I've, of course, left the link in the description to the locomotive itself. Well, to the Reskin. It's not by me. It's by British Locomotive Studios. So, go and check them out. Or, they're known as BSL. Sorry. BLS. Yeah. British Locomotive Studios, BLS. Yeah, sorry. So, really, go check them out. Plus, they do have some good routes on their website. So, I've only got to download the one route at the moment, but it's brilliant. Anyway. This will be done in a series of 3 different breaks. It should cover 4.5 hours. Yes, 4.5.
And we should be getting going there.
As I was saying, this should cover us. Right, there we go. So yeah, 3 breaks over 4.5 hours. Let's go.
touch it.
Well, not second gear, but we'll just take that down to about 50%. Anyway,
that's underway. We'll open up the doors.
Just popping in coal in every sort of now and again, so we have the sort of right amount. Anyway, am I speaking too loudly? Is the game too loud? Am I too quiet? Just let me know how everything is for you guys. Yeah, we have got overhead wires for the sort of first part of the line, and then we should be a bit more on the on clear for the rest of the line, really. So yeah, I think just outside of our first station, we'll have overhead wires for the first 10 miles, and then we should be all in the green for the rest. Right, we should be going up to about 18 miles per hour in a minute, if I think right. Yes, there we go. We should be up to 18 in a minute. Okay, we'll set that back to about 38% and allow this to pick up speed. All right. That does look amazing. I'm glad you can hear me. We'll close that in a minute, so I just need to give it a couple of minutes.
set up. Okay, so we're getting almost up to 70 miles per hour, and then once at 70, we should be able to put some more water in. Our first stop will be at Slough, which is about 20 miles out of Reading, really. Roughly 17 and a half. Pop that forward a little bit. Gives us an advantage. Pop that down. We'll have that nice and white. Right, and that's just the station we've gone through, okay. That's crazy. Almost 75 miles an hour. Sorry, miles per hour. It really does. Okay, so. Let's say this will be a very long live stream, so sit back and relax. We will just quickly save this because I know at some point it's gonna crash as train sim does. Okay, so that's now a 70 coming up. It's not too bad, let's put some water in. It's about knowing how much brake you need to put into this locomotive. Not too much, not too little. Right, there we go. Yes, the reason why it's allowing me to only use 70 is because I'm crossing over between a couple of different tracks. So that is the reason. And then for the next part of the line,
will be joined by another steam locomotive. A bit of blower, then we'll be along our way again. That's the inside of the fire, which does look amazing. Hey, we've got 7 people watching. It's awesome. Hello to everyone who's looking into the live stream at the moment. We've got 9 people. Oh, this is amazing. So, hello to everyone who's just joined. Plan is, let's have a look. So, once we get to Reading, we'll stop it for about 10 minutes and then we'll have a quick break. And then that's the same for sort of Bristol Temple Meads as well. We'll be having a break. Our first station, what do you have planned for the summer half term, Zach? Some half term, I don't know at the moment. But I'll see what's going on. What about you? Hey, we've got 8 people watching. Awesome. I think my plans for sort of over the summer is to also work, do a bit of work, quite a bit of volunteering, then not much else really. Reading, Newbury, Trowbridge, Bristol, Bridgewater and Taunton, heading for about 25 to 7 in a game. I'm only doing this for 4 hours, roughly 4.5 actually, so I should be done by about 5:30 in real life time. Okay. You're not sure either, yeah. I just see how the next couple of months go, and we'll just plan our way, really.
Okay, so we should be getting there for about 22:30 game.
Ah, hello, Oliver Gilson. How are you today? Hope you are very well.
What I'm going to do, when I get to Slough, I'm going to just turn on my mic off for a bit. Then we can just let the scenery roll by. But for now, I think it's just to save my voice for the next couple of hours, so...
Forgive me if I'm a bit... I've done live streaming, but never this long, really.
Then departing at 2:42.
Good, good. I'm glad you're okay, Oliver Gilson. Having a good half term so far?
Another green light.
That means we're getting the all green to come through most things. Now, I don't actually have any other trains really coming past us. I only planned for this one to go through everything. Alright, and there's Slough.
I don't know when this is going to run. This is basically, this is kind of down to the Severn Valley Railway, because this is just for fun, really. I say this is made up. The real locomotive's at Severn Valley, so I don't know when they plan to run it over
the bank holiday 4 day, but it should be interesting to see what it is like. While I can't attend myself to be there, I will wait for some videos to come out and I'll have it to see what people think. But yes, it's not going to the main line. This is just purely from me being a bit crazy. But a good question. Very good question indeed. But the Jubilee, the Queen's Jubilee actually herself is 2nd of June. I know for my local railway, it would be the beer festival over the Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. All open. Pictures. Running a little bit behind time, but that's okay, we can kind of make it up on the next part. Okay, so we've got one coach open, which is okay. Okay, so
let's turn
this on. Ah, hello.
So, we've made it to Slough.
Traditionally, this is where rail tours would normally run. So, for me, when I see rail tours go to Paignton and on to Kingswear, normally they start at Slough very early in the morning. Something like 8, maybe 9 in the morning, they'll leave. And then go on to being at Paignton Main Line at about midday. Again to Kingswear for about 1:45 in the afternoon. And then we'll do the journey back to Slough and heading towards midnight.
Ah! Hello, got someone new joining.
We got 10 people watching.
Right, where are we? About a minute before. I've just realised how low we are for PSI, so I've decided just to put a little bit of coal in, a bit of blower, and we should be getting going in a few minutes. We are already running about 20 seconds late. So my route is to here first. Platform 9.
Good, good. I'm glad you're okay. Nice to see you on the channel.
We've got 13 people watching. That is nuts. Oh my goodness. Okay, that's 2 ticks. Okay, and let's get going. So we're starting. And
17 and a half miles until we get into Reading.
Pop an hour.
Reverse down so we can pick up some speed. Though there is no danger, which is okay. Right, so I will talk in a bit, but for now, enjoy the journey. So I'll see you guys. Well, I'm going to carry on, of course, replying in the chat, but I'll save my voice until we get to Reading. Then we'll be straight back into it. And once we get into Reading, we'll go for about a 10-minute break, which is what you've got here. So anyway, enjoy the journey. So, we are now very near Reading. We are about 4.5 miles away. Pretty good, I will admit. We have used almost 1,000 gallons worth of water with this loco, which is rather a lot. So what we're going to do, we'll pull into Reading and then we'll have a 10-minute break. We'll be on our way to the next part of our journey. So, I hope everyone's enjoyed the live stream so far. I know I'm loving it. I'll just keep that cracked open a little bit. The fireblocker door. To basically just stop the smoke being black. Otherwise, it ends up looking like this. Oh, it's actually pretty clean. Okay. Not as bad as I thought. We might be running 2 minutes late. Maybe. It's okay, really. Very pretty in here. You've got to give it to Steam Science Preen. They've done a brilliant job on the interior of the Pullmans. When it comes to their locomotives, rolling stock routes, they have done an amazing job. So a big credit to them, because they've spent probably a good couple of years on these. Maybe a good, I don't know, 18 months? So yeah, well done to Steam Sound Supreme.
Hey, we've got 9 people watching.
Oh, very nice. A river. That tree seemed to be in.
Ooh, we've got another set of lines.
That's just warning me there's a 60 up ahead. That's into mid gear, which means we can't go anywhere once we've stopped. And this is us right here. Only about 4 minutes late, which is not too bad actually. Oh dear.
We've overshot a little bit, which is okay.
Which is... it's fine. So anyway, this is not where I'm ending it. This is where we are having a break. So, thank you for joining me on my first part of the journey to Taunton. Anyway, so I hope you've all enjoyed that first part of the journey, and we'll see you in a bit. We are just going for a quick break, and then we'll be right back on the journey from Reading. So we'll be right back. So see you in a bit, guys. So, we are back for the next part of our journey. So,
let's head back over to the game. Right, so we're in. Oops. Yes, we're in. And for our next part, we are joined by a special locomotive. We are joined by 4596 Bahamas, the Jubilee class for Bossman Games. And boy, what a surprise. It's lovely. So I thought, we'll do a double header for the next part. So here we are. And we'll be getting on going in a minute, and then we'll be heading on to our sort of last. We've got 131 miles to go left. Yes, 131 miles. It's very long. So we plan to have a break. Can we have a look? I don't know, actually. Anyway. Let's keep going. So we'll pop the reverser in for forwards. Pop a little bit of coal in. Right. And off we go. By the way, was the music too loud or was it too quiet? Just let me know on. Obviously, let me know if everything's too loud for you guys along here, because I'll try and quieten it down on either end. So, the only thing that's changed is that we're joined by Bahamas for the next part of our journey. Oh, it's looking beautiful, but I'm not the harness. Oh,
we don't really have any time limit for the next two platforms. So yes, and Newbury, we don't have a time for stopping at West Loop Junction in 57 miles, and then do have a time limit for Crow Bridge, which would be at 4:30, which is about an hour's time. Water and everything, because we have coupled up to another locomotive, it means that I can't see my own PSI and how much water I'm using, so it's kind of down for me to look out this sort of... Oh, okay, we're on a different line. That's very unexpected. But boy, does that look cool. And we've got 9 people watching again. Awesome. Hello to everyone who's just joined. Yeah, for the people who've just joined, don't worry, you haven't missed on a lot. We've just done from London to Reading, and now we're going from Reading to Taunton now. And we are joined by a Jubilee class, and it looks absolutely epic to have a double header. Here they come, flying at almost 70 miles per hour. Awesome. Here we go. Whistle time. Oh, that does look amazing. Oh, we could do 100. There we go. There we go. That looks better already. Well, that's Reading Depot, and we are doing almost 80 miles per hour, which is rather quick. Hey, MJ. Can we do it? Yes, there we go. 80 miles per hour. Oops, that's the wrong direction.
and get a photo of them.
Well, the answer is yes, we can do it. So that is pretty awesome.
Basically, me just checking on all my water, fire pressure, and everything else.
We're just currently out of life for about an hour and a half
now. We're doing well timing wise.
Very well. So, yes. For time, we're doing fine. In fact, we can do 95 now. So I think as we are getting closer towards Bristol, we can't do so much as 125. I think we are going to be limited to about 95 to 100. Maybe 110, but I noticed as you come into Devon, you seem to go slower. Which is actually okay, because Devon is not meant for speed. What are we doing from water wise? That's okay. We're just under 50%, which is all good. I think this will be a quick 35 second stop. So we don't have long at this one. I think we can have a longer break later on. Then hopefully, for like my next video, should be the Spirit of Steam video. That Train Sim World 2 have just released their first Steam Engine pack, so I will soon be doing a review on that. To tell you guys what it is like, from my point of view, to drive Steam Engine in a different simulation. And we have overshot again. Apparently my braking is pretty terrible on this. Stop. We're going to stop. Open the doors, there we go. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. 5 coaches. Which is actually pretty good. Okay, so. Right. We are up to 61% worth of water, which is brilliant. Better than I've actually done, so we'll... Can we get going? Yes, we can. Newbury in just over 6 miles. Just under 6.5. Okay, so what we can do is we can gain our pressure back by opening that up. Okay. There we go. All good. I think we'll drive it from inside the cab now, because I really need to keep an eye out on what I'm doing. Do we have sparks? We shouldn't do. Hey, we've got 12 people! Hello to everyone who's just joined. I don't know what that does. We can hear Bahamas working. Oh, that's a bit too much. Perfect. Water wise we're fine. Speed wise we're speeding up. Coal wise we're good. Pressure we are slightly not, but we're okay for that one. How far are we to go? 5 miles. That's alright. And how far do we have? Bristol temperament. I'll show you that one first. About 50 miles, which is not too bad. Maybe to 45 when we get down to 5 miles, which we are. So yeah, not too bad. I think we should be okay for time. We've got Newbury, Westbury, Westley Junction, and then Trowbridge. And then Bath Spa, Bristol Temple Meads, Bridgewater, and Taunton for 6:30. Has someone got that one? gaining our pressure back. Good. Just trying to go through everything for what I was going to mention. So, made up of water. What are we holding at? We are holding about 100 pounds of pressure. That's to tell me how much sort of steam I'm putting to the regulator, which is about 110 to 100, which is actually quite average, which is a very good thing actually. Not too much, not too little, just perfect. Well, at least it's getting us somewhere. Steam engine. Why, thank you very much, Lee. It is looking really good.
What are we doing? Okay. Not too bad.
Getting somewhere, getting there in style. Oh yeah, style is, as far as steam engines go, this has to be one of the best styles to do in. A double header with 9 Pullman coaches. Not too much.
Holding us at
60 miles per hour. Okay. Yes, my tender water is not too bad. Yes, it's just had a refill. I'm just popping some water in now, so my water will probably drop down quite a bit. Oh yeah, I've put in some ball too, and it is brilliant. But as well, I will admit, I love Train Simulator. But by far now, that train sim world two has now got steam engines. Oh, it's going to be brilliant. Ooh, we might be able to fit in. We might be able to fit in now. Can we? Can we? Oh, we're in. We're in the platform, I'm happy. Oh, well, that is just brilliant. Are we in? We're in! We're big enough for 9 coaches and a double header. Goodness. Okay, well, that's a bonus. Can we get a picture of it? Westbury Loop is 42 miles, good grief. Okay, well, I wasn't expecting it to be that much, but it is, it is. Just get a quick 8F and Jubilee. Oh yeah, those two locos are brilliant. Water-wise, we are struggling a bit. That's okay, we're going for almost 2 hours. Very close to 2 hours.
I hate this loco delivery.
It's not too bad. It's not too bad. It's lovely. I suppose they did it for the Jubilee, which what really does count. Right, okay, this is what we've got. We are gaining pressure. Open the fire box door. Yeah, BR Green is lovely. Though the real question, British Railway locos, do you prefer Great Western Green or BR Green? BR Green. Yeah, I think BR Green is very nice. But I do also quite like a Great Western Green. Like the large prairies. LMS, okay, yeah. I see your reasoning. Right, I'm just going to turn the webcam off so I let you guys enjoy the next part of
the journey.
Right. Pressure's good. Water's not too bad.
And our next journey is
41 miles away, that's why. Good, 45. If we can get up to about 70, I'll put some more water in. What's the final destination? The final destination is Taunton for this live stream, because the next one will be Taunton going to Minehead on the brand new West Somerset Railway. But yep, final destination will be Taunton. Because then I have this locomotive at Taunton on a different route, ready for another live stream. Yep, Taunton, which is rather a long way, is our last stop. And how far is Taunton? 113 miles. Thereabout. That was far too close. Once again, we've used so much water. We've used about, let's think, 600 gallons of water. I quite like this route, actually. Yeah. We're not in a town, yeah, we're currently... in countryside environment. Yeah, I quite like the countryside. PSI is building up pretty good. Very well. Water, not too bad. Right, give it some more regulator. Over the level crossing. When does it come up? And we're about to blow off. Barriers are up. Right. We are heading up to 60 miles per hour, and how far do we have? A good 35 to go. Oh, this coach looks a lot better. A lot better indeed. Hey, we've got 12 people again. Lovely. Where are we at? We should be... 33 miles. And then 37. Okay, so they're only like 4 miles apart from each other. That's good to know. Good to know we're going to not going too far between the two places. Right, I'm just going to turn my mic off for a few minutes and then I'll turn my mic back on when we are nearer our next stop. So, enjoy the journey. So, we are getting rather close to our destination. I've just realised I am using a lot of water. I was on 5,550, and now I'm on 2,016 gallons. I've pretty much used almost 4,000 gallons worth of water in maybe a good 40 miles. Just turns out to be you're using a lot in a steam engine. I'm slightly worried that I'm not going to get this done. To be honest, I think it would have been quicker just going this way instead of going by Bristol and then going through. But hey ho, we all learn from our mistakes. But this is an enjoyable route. But it's very long. Very, very long. Just I didn't quite know how long it was. Well, we're doing fine from steam, I can tell you that. Water, we're back up to 35%. It's all good. Anything else? Ooh, like a little bridge. Ooh, lovely. Nice little path. So, doop-a-doop-a-doo. Train coming. Go around the corner. Okay, we're just there. Hey, we got 10 people watching. Very nice. Hello to everyone who's just joined. Nice river. Right. That's half past. So we're going to be a bit late running to Trowbridge. Yeah. we're going to get there from about 25 to. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to skip to that and go straight. But we'll stop in Westbury Loop, but then we'll go straight to Bath Spa and then Bristol after that, which is only 35 miles. I say that because that is a lot, but it's not too bad. At least it's not 50 miles anymore. At least we're picking up speed. Sorry if it's taking forever and we're going through a lot of countryside. It's because I'm trying to balance my water, fire, and trying to do everything else. So forgive me if I'm a bit sort of slow at this. How am I going through so much water? Is something open? Well, that's done it. We're now picking up some very nice speed. Let's do it to Bahamas in a minute. And see how she's doing. Back up to 70. Nicely done. Well, the water's doing it and we're doing just under 70. We can kind of see what Bahamas is doing at the moment. So let's blow a whistle. I think after the Jubilee weekend, I will do a review on Bahamas. Well, not on Bahamas, I'll do a review on the Jubilee pack and what sort of locos you can expect with it. And then we'll go onto a route and we'll drive a locomotive and just see how it goes. That will be my next review coming up. And then obviously the steam pack for Train Sim World 2. I'll do that as well. Just trying to think of what I can get out.
far are we?
Okay, we're only about 2.25 miles. So we'll need to start to slow down in a minute. Pop some more coal in. Okay, 1.5 miles. We are coming up to Westbury West Loop. And we can only do 50. Sorry, 15. Yeah, we are late. Very late. Ooh, that looks good. So that's 50% of water, that's okay. Time to go. We were supposed to get into Trowbridge about 15 minutes ago, but given the circumstances that we're in, we are going to go straight through and go straight to Bath Spa, which is only 15 miles, and then Bristol Temple Meads is only 27 miles, and then we're only halfway there. Yeah. Just over halfway. And then Taunton. Where's Taunton? Only 72 miles. Half an hour and 40 minutes to get there. We're going to think about Bath Spa first. We're going to go straight through Trowbridge, Bridge, go straight to Bath Spa, and then Bristol Temperament. And then we might make that one, which is only 60 miles. Again, we're not going to think about that because that's too far. We're going to concentrate on the things we can do. Bridge coming up. Ooh, hello cars. Hey, now we're coming into more town scenery. Oh, that's good. Oh, who knew there could be so much countryside? That was far too much countryside, but it is good to have countryside as well as town, but I'm so glad to get back into the town scenery. We've spent somewhat 70 miles, maybe 80, off town / city, but we're back. Oops, and I should probably check up on water. Hey, we're now going back at 55 miles per hour. Hey, oh, that's good. Why are we losing steam? Steam engine. So this is Bath Spa. Oh, this is a lovely place, actually. Looks brilliant. Well, it looks like a brilliant sort of place. Sorry, no, this is not Bath Spa. This is Trowbridge. I'm sorry. But Bath Spa will look nice. So this is Trowbridge. Still a lovely place. And now we're on to Bath Spa, which is only 12 miles. And then 23. I think what I'm going to do is... Bath Spa, then Bristol Templemead, we can get in for about 5 past. Yeah, it's doable. We've now caught back a little bit of time by not stopping at Trowbridge. Just put us back in about 5-10 minutes. Oh well, I've just messed up the speed limit. I'm supposed to be doing 40, but I'm not. Oh well. Not complaining. And we are 2 hours and 45 minutes into the live stream. Almost 3 hours, actually. Which is nuts. We're looking at a bit of a push for Bristol Templemead. We should be able to do it.
Pop some coal in because we are not doing so great in that area.
So we've used half a ton of coal. And so much water. Roughly 4,500 gallons of water we have gone through. Try and speed up a little bit more. Tunnel! So that's Bradford-on-Avon. Bradford-on-Avon. Oh, okay. We've got the Union Jack logo. And so, yeah, we're good. We've got some small foot crossings into a field. And only 9 miles away from Bath Spa. And I'm enjoying a nice cup of tea. Yeah, when it comes to engine drivers and so firemen, it's a classic T. As in, it's a must. Right, we'll do that, and we won't fully close the firebox door, will start opening the regulator. It's a push. I think I should probably not go to Bath Spa. I know I said I would. Ah, hello Fraser, how are you? I know I said I'll stop at Bath Spa, but I'm now starting to think I should probably just go for the rest of Temple Meads. Good, I'm glad you're good. Ooh, we're under 1,000 gallons. Okay, that's a slight worry. Well, we're not completely done for yet. We still may have a chance. Had a good week so far, Fraser Cottrell? Normally, I don't go from London to sort of Bristol, but I think this is a really pretty scene going from sort of London to Bath Spa. Let's think about it. The scenery is actually quite incredible. So, yeah. Good job. So, whoever made a good job to this, because it looks beautiful, actually. Just forget how much countryside we have. Even though there are one or two houses, it's mostly peaceful countries. They have trains, like steam engines, which is cool. Yes, I'm not using my controller today. Just to make it a little bit easier, I thought I might just test it with a mouse again. Just to see what it's like. Well, hey, we've got 8 likes on the stream and 184 subscribers. That's amazing. And quite a lot of views as well.
Oh,
Oh dear. That's a, that's a quick and emergency stop. That is not what I wanted to happen. Right, okay, so that's a slight panic. Note. Well, running out of water very quickly. I should probably start taking my brakes off in a minute. Actually, we'll do it now. Nope, there's still locks on. Okay. That's okay. Let's give it a minute. This was Bath Spa. Oh, is this Spa? Ooh, it's like a castle. I like what they've done with this. Okay. I'll do this more often if I know about this. Oh, and that's Bath Spa, is it? Okay. Okay, so it's not too far then. But it looks beautiful. You've got a castle. Oh, that is amazing. Incredible. Okay. Okay, can we now take the brakes off? Yes, we can. Right, let's do going again. We'll go straight through Bath Spa. Then we should be somewhat 15 miles away from... Bristol Temperament. Okay, we're only 12 miles. That's not too bad. That's not too bad indeed. We might just be able to make it. Yeah, fine. We'll go to Bristol Temperament. No, I think we need another break. Then we'll try and do the last two stops along the route. So overall, it's not too bad. We've done a pretty good job. I'm only supposed to be doing 40, so that's okay. We have something to let us know in a minute, so... By the way, if you have missed this live stream while it's live, this will be a video on YouTube still. But don't you worry, because some of these screenshots will be on my Instagram, which is linked down in the description below. So after the live stream, I'll put some photos up from today, and then we get to see what it looks like. Oh no! Oh. Well, I might have been talking too fast.
Oof. To be honest, I think that puts me in enough place to finish for today. We have done this for...
how long now? 3 hours. 3 hours. And my game finally crashed. That's quite hilarious, to be honest. So, I'm not surprised, but it has been a brilliant live stream. A bit long, I will admit. But we somewhat kind of made it. We were only about 55 miles out of Taunton, so I wouldn't worry about it. Because in the end, it's all for fun, and it was quite hilarious. So I think this is where I'm probably going to wrap it up for today, because I've been going on forever. Yeah. Also, I do have a TikTok account as well, so I'll try and put some photos of there and collage it into a video. Oh, what else? Yeah, we've got some reviews coming up for on Train Simulator and Train Sim World 2 as well. And we'll just see what else is going on. My second channel is slowly going. To be honest, I haven't been using it that often, so it's a little bit of a slow go, but it's okay. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go back to
Gamers No More, which is okay.
But what we'll do is go to the interval, and then we'll just show off some of these pictures while we're here. I think what we're going to do next time is we'll run on the West Somerset line. So that'll be from Taunton to Minehead. But I'd say it was a pretty good run for today. It's a shame we crashed at the end, but it's okay. We were only 50 miles out. Anyway, I'm going to pop some music on, then we'll sort of end the live stream from there. The thing we're going to do is we're going to do King's Arthur. Trailer music. King Arthur's final resting place, I think it's called. Yes, it's remastered. Perfect. We'll draw some more photos and we'll just put up some music for a couple minutes and then we'll also end the live stream there. But overall, that was a very nice stream. I enjoyed it. Don't know about you guys, but I loved it. Shame that we crashed at the end, but as I say, all things are hilarious, so it is quite funny. But we made it into some distance. We were a bit late, but we made up some good time. So overall, that was pretty good shot for doing it. So,
I'll just turn my webcam back on.
We're waiting for it to load. Oh. Webcam. Oh dear. I think we've had a good run today. Anyway, I'll end the live stream there. Thank you very much, everyone, for watching this hilarious video. Sorry, live stream. It's been great fun to do it today, and I enjoyed making it.
Anyway,
a big thank you very much, everyone, for watching. Please do subscribe to the channel. We are so close to 200 subscribers. Also, do go and click that notification bell to be the first one to be notified on any new videos, live streams, or updates. And also, go and click that like button so I know you enjoy these contents that I'm bringing out for you guys. Anyway, thank you very much, everyone, for watching, and we'll see you within the next video or live stream. Anyway, we'll see you guys very soon. Thank you for watching, and bye-bye for now. Bye, everyone!